All right, well, thank you very much. And you know what? It's always nice talking on the Traders Pub. I know Morgan for, it's got to be almost 10 years now. And I always get, I always love listening to other speakers, other traders coming on the show. And it's funny because, you know, we have some great war stories. And it's funny, and I know you hear a lot of them, but eventually you guys are going to be part of those war stories. You're going to be shocked. And because being a trader, and you could see where we all have been born and raised from, you know, we're like professional athletes on the football field or the basketball field. And now, you know, obviously we want to take our experience and be the coaches, and that's where we come in. So a lot of great content, a lot of great education for all of you. And what I'm going to be talking about exclusively is how the high frequency trades work, following the high frequency trades. Now, this topic has been so hot that I assume everyone has been hearing and what's going on with CNBC last week, and what happened on 60 Minutes. All this scrutiny about high frequency trades and how people are getting screwed, and you know, and the bottom line is, the funny part of it all, it's not us getting screwed. It's really the mutual funds. We're like ants on the floor. Okay, but where there's a catastrophe, there are opportunities for all of you. So this is where I'm going to talk to all of you. So it'd be a very fun topic to talk about. I'm so excited because it gave me a lot of advertisement when they were talking about this. This is all I really teach. This is one of the main topics that I focus on. This is 70% of the volume of the market. Now, I only have 45 minutes to speak. So just to let everybody know, I'm going to be doing another at the end of this presentation. If you guys want to come and join me tomorrow and watch me trade live at the end of this presentation, I'm going to run a promotion where you can watch me for a full week live in the market. And the best part about how I trade is not to judge me on my winners, but how and judge me on my losers and how few of them they are. And it's seeing all those high-frequency trades trading the market. And that's what I'm going to show you. So, a little history about myself, not to bore you, but I've been teaching people since 1995. And like Morgan says, I live here in New York, financial capital of the world. I was trained by the best traders on Wall Street, from Goldman, Merrill, all the top traders all over the world, right here in New York. And I'm one of the original Soles Bandits that started. If you read any of the old books, basically we were day traders, but market makers didn't like us too much, so they called us little bandits. You could read about that. Also, I helped NASDAQ develop their ETFs, their ECNs, which are basically ETFs today. And basically also, which I don't know if everybody knows, I'm a 12-time champion. I've beat every single school in the industry. That's right, Harvey Halkin, God bless his soul, judges. You know, poor guy just died recently, about a couple of years ago, too. But yes, all the way back since the Harvey Halkin days, was able to be trained by him also a little bit of what he – all right. So, but you know what? Nothing has changed for what happened there is today. ETFs are losing big, but it's an incentive for us. So I'm going to talk a little bit about what they are. A lot of people don't know what ETFs are, so I'm going to talk about what they are and how we use them. Now, what we're going to be learning today is I'm going to talk about how online brokers make money off you. I'm going to talk about the high-frequency trades. I'm going to talk about level three, total view. I'm going to talk about charts, the KISS method, keeping it simple, and stocks that we've traded, and much, much more. All right? So what are the big thing is HFTs rigged. The debate is getting hotter by the minute. Well, first of all, what high-frequency trades are basically orders that people are saying that exchanges are front-running 0.3 of a second faster than the rest of the Wall Street. You know, you got to understand something. We've all came from the days when we used to pay fractions, you know, not decimals. We went from paying 12 cents to 24 cent spreads to penny spreads, okay? We went from trading, dealing with traditional stockbrokers, charging us $50, $100, $150 a ticket, to paying, you know, pennies on a ticket, okay, a trade, a dollar a ticket. So, you know, if somebody's going to be making 0.3 of a penny on me because he wants to be a second faster than me, God bless him. At the end of the day, you and I, that's not going to affect our 1,000 shares, okay? These stocks move all day long. But the benefit of it is that you can see these orders. And that was what was driving me crazy listening on TV. I'm like, you know what? Not one person on that TV show, not one anchor, brought up the situation of Total View. And that's what we're going to talk about. That's what we're going to kind of talk about right now. So let me change the slide here. And before we do that, let's talk about a little bit about what is what we call direct access. So, and how it works and what level two is and all that good stuff. Now, before we move on, I just want to get to know a little bit about everyone here. Can everyone just give me a chat back and let me know what kind of trader is everyone? Are you stock trader, a day trader, swing trader, an investor, options, Forex, futures? Okay. Couple options traders here. Got some Forex. Good. Day trading beginner, Wayne. Okay, good, good. An instant consistent trader. Well, listen, Mike, there's always a way to fix that problem. Anything that makes money, Jiz. All right, scalping, not very good at it. Okay, Marty. Well, first of all, you have to ask yourself a question is, who really trained you? Okay, are you self-taught or were you trained by somebody? And who was that person? I could tell you this. It's very difficult to be successful, to be self-trained. I know I wouldn't want a doctor to do brain surgery on a loved one, on my loved ones. That is self-taught, if you know what I mean. We all need education. We all need mentors. And it's okay, David and Michael, we learned the hard way. I learned the hard way. I lost hundreds of thousands of dollars of my own money when I started being some ignorant 22-year-old kid because I thought I knew how to trade because I lived here in New York. You know, out there. It's not, it's trading is quite as simple, but it's not easy. Okay. Now, the biggest mistake, 50% of you are going to lose money in the market, 50, because you have the wrong brokerage account. That is one of the reasons why. And that is one of the biggest mistakes that I find. There is a difference between online brokers and direct access brokers. Online brokers, what they do is they make money on your. This is how online brokers make money. Okay, and by the way, about all the HFTs, I mean I could talk about it for hours. I could just tell you it's not going anywhere. You know what's going to probably end up happening? What I'm going to tell you right now, what's happening right now. All they're going to do is they're going to put a disclaimer on your account statement, and let me prove to you how that's going to happen. Any of you here trading, and plus it makes the volatility that HFTs are generating in sales for in taxes, exactly. Do you know how much the SEC, you ever see the SEC fee on your sales? You ever see that? You guys ever calculate and think how much money that adds up at the end of the year? You know that little SEC fee? Every execution, that's right. You think they want to lose that volume? Think they want to lose that tax? Okay? Trust me, it's not going to go anywhere. All they're going to probably do is they're going to disclose it, which what they're doing now, and I'll tell you. Let's talk about Charles Schwab, okay? The big news about Charles Schwab. Charles Schwab came out and said that HFTs was cancer. Did anybody hear about that? Anybody hear about it? I literally almost fell off my chair when he said that. I'm like, I have all the respect in the world about this guy. But it's like, is he a hypocrite? He makes his money on this stuff. He makes his money on HFTs. It's called payment for order flow. Does anybody know what payment for order flow means? Anybody hear about it? Because it's so funny. The next day they were talking about it on CNBC. They're like, what's he talking about? He makes money on this stuff. Wayne, you know what it is. Okay, that's right. They're making money on your order. Basically, what they're doing, that's exactly right, RB. They're order and they're selling it to another brokerage firm and getting paid on the side for it. Okay, that is how online brokers make money. And not only that, but they're not even executing your trade in the market. Some of them are actually trading against you. They're like casinos. They're betting against you because they know more people lose money in the market than make money. And they're allowed to do that. They're allowed to do that. All they have to do is disclose it. Okay? So this is where direct access comes in. Direct access is instant access to the market. There's no middleman. There's no payment for order flow. There's no HFTs. There's none of that. You have a seat on the exchange. You, ladies and gentlemen, could drive your own car. You deal with online brokers. You deal with public transportation. You're dealing with direct access. You're driving your own car. So this is what I need all of you to do for homework. Okay, everybody got a pen and paper? I want you to write this down. At the end of this conversation, at the end of my presentation, I want you to call your brokerage firm up and ask them, you know, is my trades direct access? And if they are, okay, now most of them don't even know what the hell it is, okay, because you're going to deal with some, no offense to anybody, you know, that's employed by these companies, but they're not traders. You have to ask them, is my orders direct access or is it an online trade? Because if one, and you all know, what's the difference between driving a car and dealing with public transportation? A substantial difference. So you have to keep that in mind. Now, some of them are very good, like Thinkorswim, very good company. Nothing wrong with them. You know, they are direct access, but they don't give you direct access to ECNs. So one of the things that I do is, I don't know, has any of you guys ever done trades like posted orders on NASDAQ and ARCA, these ECNs? These are the exchanges. Do you ever go out there and post orders? I do this in my class. I show people. It knocks them off their socks to see an actual physical order go out there. One person out of 400 people, one person saw it. Oh, you guys are going to die. When you come and see me tomorrow, you're going to be knocked off your socks. You're going to sit there and fall off your chair. Guaranteed. Right. You can route it to anybody, but you're not dealing with payment for order flow, and you're not dealing with brokerage firms trying to make money on your orders, and you're not dealing with brokers that are acting as casinos and are trading against you. Okay? But how many exchanges do you go to post your orders? Basically, RB, just one. The biggest one is NASDAQ. I like to use NASDAQ. ARCA is probably the next biggest one, but, you know, those are the two biggest. Okay? So what is level two? Let me get my crayons out here. All right, there we go. Hold on 1 second. All right, so anyone here know read level two quotes? Marty, you have to wait to the end of the presentation, okay? So you're not going anywhere for about the next 30. I'll tell you in 30 minutes. All right. B stands for buyers. S stands for sellers, okay? Now, there's level one, level two, and level three. There's three different levels to see a stock, how it's trading. Level one is the best bid and best offer. Okay, that's what you see on the ticker, on CNBC, and when you look up a quote on the internet. Level two is going to show you who's buying it and who's selling it. And number three, right here, these are the columns. These are people looking to sell the shares, the price they want to buy it for, and the amount of shares they're looking to buy. And that's a bad color. We'll go back to red. On the sell side, these are people looking to sell in column one. Column two is the price. And column three is the amount of shares. You ever guys ever get partial tickets? You know, you get partial tickets, you're like, why do I get these partial tickets? Well, you can only buy what somebody's willing to sell you. So now you can actually see the true data who's actually out there. Now, by the way, everyone, for everyone here has questions, I'll try to answer them. There's a lot of people in here. I'm very short with time. So I'm going to try to get through this pretty quickly. So please, you know, if I don't get to your answers, please be patient with me, okay? So when it comes to level two, now you're seeing buyers and sellers, and whoever wants to buy for the most amount of money is up on top. Whoever wants to buy for less money is down at the bottom. Whoever wants to sell stock for the least amount of money is up on top. Whoever wants to sell it for less money is down at the bottom. So where does level three comes into play? What is total view? What are dark pools? Those are trades going in between the bid and ask that, you know, something that's the least of your worries. Something that we used to call SelectNet when I started. It's just trades going in between the bid and ask with different brokerage firms that don't get advertised, you know, in the true market. That's all, Diggy. Okay? Nothing that you have to worry about. And actually, I have an article on, if you want to read a little bit more about it, I'll give you my email address at the end of this presentation. Here, I'll give it to you guys right now. FaustoP@ctucorp.com. And I don't think I can put an announcement, but I think Trading Pub has to put an announcement. They could put an announcement with my email address for you. So let's get into talking a little bit about what is level three. Well, level three actually shows you all the orders. This is what I was going crazy when I was watching on TV, why nobody was talking about this. This is where you see all the high-frequency trades. Thank you very much for that, Morgan. So there's my email address. Now, level three, what you're seeing is the same thing on level two. These are the buyers. These are the sellers. But now what you're seeing is all the orders. Now, we don't know who's buying it. We don't know who's selling it. It's not important. What is important is seeing all the orders. So you have to understand something. Now, listen carefully, okay? You might have somebody wants to buy 100 shares. Goldman might want to buy 100 shares at 20, at 40, 250, but he's also a buyer of 14,000 at 41.35. Now, on level two, you're only going to see his best bid and best offer. You're not going to see all his bids and all his offers. So you're getting over 20 times more data when it comes to trading. Now, a question for everyone, all right? A question for all of you. How do stocks go up and down in the market? What drives stocks up and down in the market? You should all be able to answer this question. Supply and demand. Exactly. Could you, everyone put that in there? Come on, Alvin, Ben, Bill. I don't know what you guys are nervous about. No one's going to pick on you. I mean, unless you don't talk. So could everyone put that in there? Supply and demand. Don't you all agree? Supply and demand. We know it's not, you know, we know it's not Obama. We know it's not Fausto. We know it's not Goldman. We know it's not, you know, Bernanke. We don't know it's not, you know, China. We don't, it's supply and demand. Okay, buyers and sellers. Now, this is the million-dollar question. When you trade a stock, do you guys see the supply and demand in the stock? Think about it. Do you guys see it? Yes or no? That's right. Not if you only have, you don't have level three. So a lot of you saying no. Well, how much is that data worth to you? What would you pay if you were able to see all the orders, 70% of the volume in a stock that you're trading? What is it worth to you? What would you, I mean, could you put a price tag on it? Well, John, I know you don't have the platform, but you can get it. What's it worth to you? What would you willing to pay to get that data? Could you put a price tag on it? Is it worth $50? Is it worth $10? Is it worth $2,000? It's kind of hard to say, right? Depends on what you're looking to make. But at the end of the day, what is my point that I'm getting to? The data is available for you, so why not use it? Why not get it? Why not be able to see the supply and demand? And this is why people lose money in the market, because you're not seeing the true data. You're not seeing the real orders. You know, I do a lot of speakings, okay? I don't know, have any of you guys ever seen me do a speaking before? Out of curiosity, anybody ever seen me do speakings? Some of you have, okay? I do a lot of them all over. I know I do a lot of these webinars, but I also do a lot of traveling all over the world. And one thing I love to travel is I go to a lot of the expos, and, you know, listen, great traders never stop learning, okay? I sit and listen to other speakers all day long. Listen, if I had something to give me an advantage, why not? You know what the most popular seat, which is what attracts the least amount of people to show up on, to listen, is the exchanges. I was at the New York Expo, and I was at the Las Vegas Traders Expo. And I'm sitting in the audience, and I sit there every year and listen to what NASDAQ has to say. And you know what they preach all day and they keep talking, their presentation is about? Total view. And you know what they keep saying? They just keep pointing out, they're like, listen, go to a school and who talks specifically on total view. You could take courses with us. You know, you could get a lot of stuff on our website, or go to a trader that trades on it. That's all they preach. You go to their website. That's all they preach. Get this data. That's what it's all about. Okay. They do need better presenters, but you know, they're nice guys there. I know them. They're pretty nice guys. But the thing is, it's not who's presenting it. It's the content that they're presenting. And that's what you have to understand. They're talking about exactly what I'm showing you. And without this data, you're trading blind. So what are high-frequency trades? They make you make smart decisions by not by having just the information, but the right information. So let's pop into a couple examples over here. Okay, you guys ready? Here we have a stock. All right. So stock goes up. Stock goes down. Stock goes up. And what happens when a stock hits a resistance levels, everyone? Anyone here know how to read a chart? What happens when you hit a resistance? What is it supposed to do? Go up or down? It's supposed to go back down, right? Okay. Now, for a stock to hit a resistance levels, what do we need? What makes resistance levels on a chart? Sellers. All right, so we have some sellers. We got 2,000 share sellers out here. But this is kind of odd. There's a 75,000 share buyer. Now, how do stocks go up and go down again? Supply and demand. What do we have more, a demand or a supply? So what do you think is going to happen to the price of the stock, everybody? Is it going to go up? Or is it going to go down like what the chart tells you? It's going to go up, exactly. Because what's more powerful than the chart? The data. Where does the chart get its data from? From orders, from transactions. Here's another example. Look at this resistance levels right here. The stock goes all the way up and it comes right back down. And you can look at here, you could see right now where we're trading at. And if you drew a trend line, hold on. Let me draw a trend line here. If you drew a trend line right there, you could see the resistance levels at that arrow and over here also, right here. That, ladies and gentlemen, and that were built by that 45,000 share seller out there at the offer. So regardless of where we're at now, I'm not talking about where we're at now because right now the stock is all the way down here. But what's making a resistance levels here is that big seller right there. So if this stock was at a support level and starts going up, you could hope and you could prepare and do every analytical thing you want. If you're thinking the stock is going back up here to 695, well, you're wrong because the only way it's going to go past that, somebody better execute this 45,000 share seller first. So you have a question. There's a couple of questions coming across here. So if you have total view, you can kick the HFTs. Well, it's not that you – listen, remember, you are ants, okay? You're getting the crumbs on the floor. Don't worry about them. They don't – the only people that are getting – affected by these are the ones that are trading millions and millions and millions in shares. And I just hate that they always put the blame that they think that, oh, it's hurting the investor, a guy like you. You think I care about 0.3 of a penny? You know, you think I care about, listen, everyone has to eat. You know, the only person's getting killed is the guys that are trading 5 million shares a day. How many are you trading? 100 shares? 1,000 shares? You think you care about someone taking away 30 cents from you? You're not looking to make 30 cents. You know, you're looking to make 300, 3,000, okay? Now, what these are called, just to let everybody know, one of the lingos, what we call these, is called iceberg orders. Have you guys ever hear that phrase? These are called icebergs or iceberg orders. That's what they are. So moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, looking, going across, you could see how VVUS has block orders. These are big block orders out there. Yeah, huge chunks. Basically, that's what they are. You could see how there's resistance levels right here, and you always need to have a game plan, and boom, look at the orders right here. You're talking 12,000, 10,000. I could tell you this, a 400 share seller is not going to make a resistance levels, but definitely that 10,000 share. And then when you look at a chart and then you start saying, what is that big seller doing out there? And then when you implement it to the chart, then you know which side you're on. Now, when it comes to support resistance levels on level 3, you know, you have to understand that what makes support and resistance levels is buyers and sellers. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the biggest problems that people have today. You don't have a game plan. Look at this example right here. We are right now, look at the time, 10:57. Everybody see that? Look at the time in sales. Look at all those sales. Look at the resistance levels. Look at the big chunk orders out there. There are orders already out there. It's not the indicator that makes resistance levels. It's the orders that make resistance levels. Watch what happens when I change the slide. At 11 o'clock, look what happened to the price of the stock. Now we're down to 487, and look at these orders over here being posted. Okay, does everybody see that? Level 2 and level 3 is like a Ferrari gets a Volkswagen. I would say a Ferrari versus a local bus. Volkswagen, you still could drive it, right? You know, when it comes to a bus, you're still dealing with someone else that's driving it for you, and they're trying to make money on your order on top of it. You know, the whole idea is the driver and the company don't care about where they're getting you. They'll just get you there, okay? They're looking to make more money in their pocket by getting more people in the bus, as many they could fit in there, and sell as many tickets as possible, and all you think you're getting is a little ticket fee. Well, sometimes cheap is not always the way to go. My father always taught me, and he says, son, the only thing is free is the cheese in the mouse trap, okay? And you know what happened to the mouse when he took the cheese? Now, here you go, and remember, ladies and gentlemen, I don't work for the brokerage firms. I'm not a brokerage firm. I am a trader just like you. Not only did he got fat, he got killed with the mouse. So the thing is this, everybody, you got to keep in mind, you got to have a game plan. Now, I got one more last slide on high-frequency trades I want to show you, okay? You see the resistance levels right here at 10:20, okay? Everybody see that? Okay, that was built by this guy right here, all right? So the stock, you had support levels, resistance levels, support levels, resistance levels. Now the stock is back to a support level, right? So in theory, the stock should go up. Well, to have a support level, you need buyers. Do you see a 10,000 share buyer out there? I know I don't. And without no buyers, guess what? If somebody comes out there and starts executing 100 share clips, that thing is going to go down pretty damn quickly. And let me tell you, you're not the only one trading the stock. I trade 2 million shares. That's right. And you're probably going to end up going all the way down to here. There's only 1,000 shares at that 90. You're probably going to go all the way down to 1570, which is 40 points, 40 cents lower. And 40 cents might not sound like a lot to you. I don't know about you, but you know, it's a lot to me because 40 cents on 1,000 shares is $400. Marty, that's exactly what my mentors taught me. They says, why you got to try to beat them? Just join them. Follow the money. That's all you need to do. So at the end of this presentation, everybody, I'm going to be done in about another 15 minutes, 15, 20 minutes. But I'm going to tell all of you, if you want to come and join me, you know, because everyone here, I mean, this looks great. You know, here you see, you say here, wow, Fausto, it makes so much sense. I like it. But you know what? Don't judge me on my PowerPoint. Judge me on reality, which at the end of this presentation, I'll tell you how you could join me in the real market conditions and see it live in the market tomorrow morning, okay? Now, finding stocks. Let me tell you about how to find stocks, all right? I don't care what I trade. I just want to make money. You think I care about the Dow being down today? You think I care about a stock symbol that I shorted today? Did anybody hear about IMPV today? Anybody hear about IMPV? Anybody hear about it? Did you did? Where'd you hear about it? No one heard about IMPV? IMPV. IMPV. Put it in the chat. Down almost 50% today. Exactly. Okay, down 50%. Okay, some of you said you don't trade stocks. Okay, so some of you trade options, I assume, right? We have a lot of options traders here because I forgot to mention something about you guys. Okay, let me explain to you all you option traders. You want to be a good option trader? Okay, you want to be a good option trader? Well, you don't make the first biggest mistake that you make is you have to learn how to trade stocks first, because it's the movement of the stock that makes the option move. So if you understand why the stock is moving, then you know why to trade the option. A lot of people lose money trading options because they trade it like a poor man playing a rich man's game, and that's not how you trade options. All right, remember, it's the movement of the stock that makes the option move. And you know what? That stock symbol, IMPV, if you knew it was a short all day, which is what I was tweeting all day and I was trading in the pre-market, if you didn't want to trade the stock, you could have traded the option and could have still made a lot of money on it also. All right. Now, getting back to finding stocks. Finding them is pretty easy. Now, on my I run a professional trading room, which all of you could join me at the end of this presentation. And I have a scanner up running all day long, and I show you how to scan the market, how to find stocks in the market, what's moving in the market, and so on. And basically, most of the money that I make is in the morning. Now, who here doesn't want to only work an hour a day? I know it sounds, you know, ridiculous, but yeah, I mean, trading is a part-time job. Most of the money is made in the first 30 minutes of the hour, okay? That's right, less is more. Trading is not a full-time job. You know what a full-time job is, being in the trading business? Take a guess. Where is most of your time being spent in the trading business? That's right, teaching. 10% of your time is spent on trading. 90% of your time is spent on education. Once you learned how to trade, you know that you got that 90% free of time to do whatever you want. But in the beginning, you're learning. And most of the action that's being made is in the first hour of the open. Now, what I do is I do a meeting, a live broadcast at 9 a.m. We do Forex at 8 a.m. Eastern. I do stocks at 9. I show you how to read the pre-market due to what's happening with the high-frequency trades, and that will dictate and tell you of the direction of the stock, because a lot of these orders in pre-market are getting ready to execute all the orders at the open. And that's why you get a lot of action and a lot of the great volatility in the morning. So timing during the day, you could see this is where the money's being made, right there. That's where you make most of your money, right at the open. Let me clear this out. Hold on. Yeah, this is actually a day This is 9:44, 15 minutes. And these are all the trades I did right at the open where I was trading at my positions when the market opened up. What stock symbol is this? Plug. Yeah, Plug. We were trading Plug before anyone was even knew what Plug was. And the only reason why I found Plug, not that I'm a genius, I have insider information. It's just it was popping up in my scanner and was breaking all-time highs. Now, seeing HFTs on time and sales, that's the next biggest thing. You see a lot of these big orders. I don't know if you guys use time and sales, but I show you to see if those orders are getting executed. And not only that, but color coordinating time and sales is going to give you a sense of direction where those trades are taking place. John says, how do you get these stocks that come out hot? John, that's the easiest question to answer. Come and join me tomorrow morning, and I'll show you. Can you do that? Could you come and see me tomorrow? You be up there bright and early. Early bird gets a worm. And you know what? If you can't make it, it'll be recorded, and it'll also be I'll tweet it, and I also text message it, everything. If you join your class and we make a boatload of money, will the SEC investigate us as insider trading? Absolutely not. We're not doing – you know what insider trading means? Insider trading means you work for the inside of the company and you know information that's out before it was available for the general public. We don't do any insider trading. What we're doing is we're trading the market and we're seeing what's happening due to the action in the pre-market and we're just trading. There's nothing illegal about that. But no, I like that. That's a great point. And believe me, I've trained a lot of agents that work for the federal government over the years. And believe me, they didn't find anything wrong. Been doing this for 20 years, okay? And I know they sat in my class many a times. Listen, let me tell you, they want us to train you. They don't want to see you guys lose money. One of the reasons why ECNs came out in the first place is because the exchanges didn't like that market makers were dictating the prices of the stock. It was up to them what they thought the price of the stock was. They didn't like that. They were held hostage. The companies were held hostage to these brokerage firms because whenever you wanted to buy and sell a stock, you had to do it through them. So, and that's why they go out and they tell you guys about this stuff. So, anyway, go into the KISS method. Let's talk about the charts. First of all, I just want you guys to know, charts, you got to be really careful because some of you get a little too overwhelming with charts. I preach something called the KISS method. Keep it super simple. Some of you guys get so created, you can't even see where the damn thing is. Remember, the problem with indicators is they're lagging. And you don't want to be a lagger. You want to be a leader. So when it comes to charts, you know, be very, very careful. And I really stress this out when I teach my classes. I would rather follow the money all day than follow some lagging indicator all day. So trading in the market, I mean, listen, there are a lot of stocks that are moving in the market. A lot of them, these are the stocks that I traded. I mean, I show my trades when we're trading. But the thing is, you know, what I try to do in my classes, guys, and what I teach in my trading room, I don't go out there and I try to show you how good a trader I am. I try to teach you how to figure it out on your own. I'm like your parent. You're my child. Eventually, I got to kick you out of the house. I'm going to teach you and prepare you for life. And I know that a lot of you here are parents. And I know a lot of you, I don't know, they did the statistics. I think we spend like almost $300,000 to $400,000 over since the baby is born till the time we kick them out of school. Okay, I think that's how much money they say we spend over the course of 20 years of trying to of doing the right thing for per child. That's a lot of money. That's literally like almost $50,000, whatever it is, between college, diapers, formula, everything. Well, I look at the same thing of you. I look at you guys as my children, And my thing is this, I'm here to train you as best as I can, but I'm not looking to hold you hostage. I want you to learn how to figure it out on your own. So I run a professional trading room, and you'll see what it's like to be in a real positions, but you're not going to look at it, what I'm trading. I'm also kind of teaching you how to figure it out on your own. Now, we tweet and text all our trades. This was March 30th, okay? These are tweets from my students in my trading room. Did you guys hear about BIOF? Did any of you guys saw the trade BIOF on Monday on April Fool's Day? Anybody see that stock? BIOF. Wayne, you did. Wayne's the only lucky one. What happened, Wayne? Who could tell me what happened with the BIOF? No one knows? Does anybody have an execution system in front of them? Come on, is everybody sleeping? I didn't make you guys fall asleep, did I? It kicked ass. The stock went up 100% in one day. Rory's like, what is BIOF? It's a stock symbol. Okay, it's right here. The stock literally went up 100%. Actually, in the first hour, the stock took off over 100% in one day. I saw people make money in the trading room, Wayne. Okay, good. Wayne, you're in my trading room right now? Wayne? I just wanted to ask Wayne about that. Every day. Okay, I know I have a few Waynes in my trading room. So Wayne could really kind of justify it. This is my tweet that I did at 9 a.m., actually 9:15 in the morning. And you can see the BIOF is right there. And then these are the trades that two of my traders tweeted. One of them made $30,000 in it. Brett M. And then Mike 2012 did $13,000 he made on that. Goes, what a trade, money on it. So my traders did really, really well on the stock, more than I obviously would anticipate. But my goal, I try to teach how to make about $200 to $500 a day. That's my ultimate goal. So the thing is this. What is BIOF? Who cares? Okay, the whole thing is it's going up. It was moving in the market. We found it in the pre-market. We traded it once the stock opened up in the morning, and we all did very, very well. Now, that is just one of very few. I mean, yesterday, okay, DANG, D-A-N-G, look it up, okay, made a lot of money in D-A-N-G. Another stock yesterday, CTCT, okay? I'll just put these symbols. Check them out. And you could see them all on my Twitter page, all right? CTCT, DANG, look them up, okay? And you'll see these are the stocks that I try to teach my students, not to trade them because they're great companies, but to trade them because they have great volatility, great opportunity, and a way for you to take home to make money, okay? So once again, I don't care what I trade. I don't want to know what the companies do. All I care about is I want to teach you how to find stocks that move 20 to 50% a day, make a day's pay, try to make a living, supplement your Social Security, maybe start trading your IRA, don't worry about going back 9 to 5. You know, listen, having a secondary job or just working part-time. Because let me tell you, and every instructor here will tell you the same exact thing I'm going to tell you right now, and they will guarantee me 100%. Trading is the best job in the world. You are your own boss. You can come and go whenever you please. You could do this anywhere in the world. So why not have somebody teach you how to do it right? I love what I do. I enjoy it. I love teaching you guys. You know, I love going out there, having fun with my students, making money like Brett, who made $30,000, and Mike. But, you know, and that's just recently. I mean, they had a lot of money today and yesterday. You know, but that was one of the big grand slams that we had, I want to show you. It's not a job. It's a way of life. It's right. You're absolutely right. You're going to be doing this for the rest of your life. Who here doesn't have an IRA? You can't tell me you're not going to be trading the market. You're not going to be trading. Why are you going to give it to some mutual fund to go out there and lose it for you? I'll lose it myself. You know, I'll go out there and lose it myself. What I need them for? They're doing the same exact thing you're doing. All you're doing is giving them buying power. That's all you're doing. So why 80 to 90% of the traders fail? Exactly what I got right here. Because some of you are not learning to trade. And by the way, this is me. And this is you. There we go. All right. So basically, you need a mentor. You need somebody to show you how to do things right. You need someone that how to teach you how to trade the game. It's one of the greatest jobs in the world, okay? But trading, you have to learn how to play it and have fun. Trading is a lot of fun. Think about it. You are now, you know, you now have access to the same technology as every brokerage firm and every market maker, you know, what they were doing. Okay, that's why you'll notice a lot of us that are here today, we're all market makers. Because you know what? We don't need to be on the floor. Actually, most of them lost their jobs because everything became computerized. So now we're just teaching you how to play the game. You know, we're not looking to trade 30, 50 million shares a day. Looking to make a couple of bucks just to get by. And believe me, getting back to the ant story, it really is coming down to that. You don't need to make a lot in this market to not have an impact, to make an impact in this market, because you're not going to make an impact. You do. You need to write entry. That's right, John. You need to write entry points and everything else. Now, there's my email address. I don't know if you guys have it, but I know one of you did mention to me you wanted to learn more about the dark pools. You want an article. Be happy to send it to you. There's my email address, faustop@ctucorp.com. All right, so there's that. Where are we at? There we go. Okay, so who wants to join me tomorrow? Well, let me tell you a little bit about, once again, for some of you don't know this, I know some of you guys logged in a little late. I'm going to give you that Twitter page, Martin, in a minute. Okay, it's on the next slide, actually. I'm a 12-time champion at the Money Show and Traders Expo. I have beat every single school that I compete against, every one of them. I was also ranked number one school 6 years in a row by Equities Magazine, okay? And if you want to see what a true, real champion has traded, and I know some of you have been to the Money Show and Traders Expo, there's not some full, you know, some company you never heard of, all right? So I've been doing it for years, and honestly, I probably would have been a 25-time champion if I was able to get some more people that wanted to go up against me, I'll be honest with you. So I'm only at a 12. But ranked number one school 6 years in a row by Equities Magazine, a lot of fun. Now, many times at the Traders Expo. Good to see you, and a great show. Now, about my Twitter and YouTube channel. My Twitter, we got two Twitter accounts. This one is the free version. We also have a paid version, which you guys are going to be able to get access on the next slide. This is what we run at the end of the day to give you a recap, okay? If you want to watch some of our trading videos, I know you guys love to do videos. Listen, there's our videos right there. Go to our YouTube channel. You'll be able to watch some short clips, a little bit about who we are, stocks that we traded, you know, and all that stuff. So you got two places you can start following us out there. Now, if you want to start learning today, now my goal is what I teach students is how to make 200 to 500 a day. That's my goal. 20 to 50 cents a day in the market makes the wife happy, or your husband, married, or the boyfriend or girlfriend. So if you want to learn how to do that, okay, basically what I'm going to be offering all of you is a one-week trial of my trading room. It's $19. Now, I have to charge you. I would do it for free, but for compliance purposes, we can't let anybody in there without doing this. Basically, this is what you're going to get, okay? $19. I am literally prostituting myself. I'm going to give you a foundation course. I'm going to give you you're going to get an ECN book workshop. I'm going to teach you how to trade. You know, there's going to be videos up there, everything, and you are going to be trading with me for 1 week straight from 9 in the morning to 4 o'clock in the close for one whole week. Okay? Now, this is what I want you to understand. I do not want you to judge me on my winners. I want you to judge me on my losers and how few I have. All right? And that is what you need to see. And I want you to judge me as an interview to see, can Fausto teach me how to make money? Is this the mentor I've been looking for? Because if this is what you want to do, then definitely you want to go out there and you want to sample it, all right? Now, this is an exclusive event for 1 week only, okay? And it's through the Trading Club. So if you want to get in there, what I'm throwing, if you register today, I'm throwing in, okay, I'm throwing in there also 4X meeting at 8 a.m. That's a bonus, okay? And I'm also going to give you the workshop. It's almost a $500 value. It's usually we only give you the 1 week trial, but I'm going to throw in these two specials, the 4X and the workshop, ECM workshop with it. How much to invest does it take to generate $200? You know what? If you buy a stock at $5, if it moves 20 cents, it's $200. How much money you need, David? Not a lot. I train you how to trade against the least, less expensive stocks, not penny stocks. I don't do any of that junk. I'll be honest with you. I trade NASDAQ National, but I show you how to trade stocks that are going to be less risk, more reward, so you don't have to compete against the best traders on Wall Street. There's my personal email address, FaustoP@ctucorp.com. You can go there. Now, you can also call us, 877-70-CYBER, 516-280-5350. And also, just to let you know, one last thing. When you register, you need to talk to one of the education advisors here, because the education advisor is going to tell you what you're going to get, how to access your dashboard, how to get those videos. It's very simple. When you register, everything will already click in. I mean, we just launched our new website after 2 years. Over the years of making, we have these things down to a science. So for everybody here, if you're interested, take a chance. The worst thing that could happen is you learn something. Now, let me see. What happens if you have our free per day? We don't do it per day, Martin. It's for one whole week. Because you know what? Some days are better than others. And if you can only show for one day, listen, that's fine. At least you get a day what it's like to be in a real trading room. I'm in a Forex, interested in Forex. Chris, tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., we're going to do a Forex broadcast. We have instructors. Actually, Greg McDermott's one of our top Forex instructors. He worked on the floor of the Philadelphia Exchange as a market maker. He does that class, that live broadcast, what to trade going into the Forex market. So that starts at 8 a.m., Chris. All right? Any other questions that I can answer? Hey, did you guys learn anything today? How about that? Good. Always learn something. Excellent. It starts tomorrow. If you start today, you're going to start your lessons today, start reviewing that recording. So it starts tomorrow. And like I said, you guys can call up and talk to, we have education advisors standing by. And if you have any questions, if you sign up, call them up and they'll tell you what you need to do for moving forward. Is this for experts or for beginners? Both. I you know what? I don't think anybody here is really an expert. You know, I mean, no disrespect to anyone here. And if you are, you could always learn something new. But I treat everybody as a beginner. Would it be better to start on Monday to get the Monday through Friday? You know, Alan, if that's what you want to do, call the education advisor to do that. But you know what? Yesterday and today were great market conditions. And after what happened, the market came down substantially today, you know, listen, there's no reason to put anything on hold unless you can't be there. Tony, no, that's not necessarily true. You could open a prop account, you know, and you could also apply this towards investing and swing trading. All right. What's the observations trading a bear market versus a bull market? Well, a bear market, you make more money. Whatever goes up comes down twice as fast. Brokers I recommend, I can't tell you that. You know why? Everyone here is a case-by-case basis. Depends what trader you are, what country you come from, different rules and regulations. What we do is when you're a student of ours, We sent out a questionnaire to know a little bit about you, and then we'll give you a list of brokerage firms who we could find out will be best for you specifically. Anybody that tells you, oh, this guy's the best, you know what? He's the best for him, but he's not maybe not be the best for you. So you can't look at it that way. First of all, Netflix, I would never trade Netflix. Why am I going to trade a stock like that when I could trade a stock like today, or BIOF, and I'm risking 100 times less money and making 100 times more, reward. Remember, just because I don't trade stocks because it's Netflix. You know, I don't know about you, but you like trading against the best traders on Wall Street? I know I don't. Prop means proprietary trading. That's what that means. That's a prop account, proprietary trading account. All right, everybody. Listen, time's running out. I want to give you guys some time to register for tomorrow. You got 16 minutes to the next presenter. First of all, I got to thank Morgan for running another awesome, awesome trading pub event. I know you got a bunch of speakers coming on next. This is what it's all about, guys. Your time is not being spent on trading. Most of your time is spent on education, and you could always learn something new from all the speakers here. And you're going to notice that we all trade very similar, specifically when it comes to discipline and psychology. So if you want to be successful in trading and you really want to learn, let me just tell you one last thing, ladies and gentlemen. This is very important. And listen, I'm being honest and sincere. You want to make money in the market? Do you really, really, really want to make money and learn? You got to get a mentor. You cannot be a self-taught individual. Okay? It doesn't work. Think about it. Would you give your money to a financial analyst that never learned how to trade the market? Well, you're doing the same exact thing. Because if you think education's expensive, try ignorance. So enjoy the rest of the presentation, ladies and gentlemen. Hope everyone enjoys it. Hope you learned a lot. Thank you for coming. And I hope to get the opportunity to teach every single one of you tomorrow. Once again, $19. It's peanuts. Doesn't cost anything. It just pays our compliance bill just to make sure to know that who we are, who's getting in there. Try us out for a week. If you can only show up for one day, show up for one day. The course is recorded. The class is recorded. You can always review that in the meantime. All right, guys? Thank you so much. Thanks, Trading Pub. And everyone, have a great weekend and happy trading.